right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Rajesh Sharma. He is the CEO of Fancamp Exploration. And Rajesh, it's great to see you. How are you?
I'm good. Great to see you as well. Thank you very much.
Yeah, excited to learn a little bit more about the company. I know you've had a lot of news out recently as well, so we'll get to that in just a second, but maybe give me some overall thoughts on Fancamp Exploration.
Okay. Just for the uninitiated, Fancamp is a mineral exploration company listed on the TSX Venture Exchange, and the stock symbol is FNC. We have numerous mineral properties, and it's got a very diversified base in base metal, precious metals, rare earth minerals, and titanium properties spread across Quebec and Ontario. The company also has some very critical and important strategic investments, namely one in Champion Iron, producing mine in Labrador Trough. We also have invested in a near-term producing zinc mine, EDM Resources. And recently, we made an investment in a private company called Neoterix Mining for exploration of rare earth minerals. So we have quite a diversified investment portfolio. Mm-hmm. We also are involved in technology play with the titanium extraction strategy. And the whole kind of objective of that is to complement the pigment industry and our own mineral resources. We have a great leadership team, good board, and the company is uniquely poised in the sense that it's got a very strong balance sheet with more than 20 million cash and marketable securities. And it's diversified and in number of strategic minerals.
Is that by design, especially the way the markets are these days? It's always good to have interest in a lot of different things, especially when you're talking about the ones that you're involved in, because they tend to fluctuate up and down. So is that by design to do it like that?
So I wish I could say that it's by design, but yes, that's one of our strengths, the way you mentioned just now. Because the company has existed for more than 30 years and it assembled a very wide range of properties. So this strength of the company, we are trying to leverage by having focused, exploration strategies. And that's where we have, plans to rationalize the portfolio, which we have already done, which we are advancing select properties, which I would just talk about. And also actively market, option out, or JV other properties, which we believe would find a better house elsewhere. So to that extent, it's a great diversification play, which, de-risks us from the, cyclicity of individual commodity markets. And also in addition, as I mentioned, we have the titanium technology where we have advanced in terms of developing the patents, testing the concept and getting strategic partnerships. And also with our strong balance sheet and cash position, we are uniquely poised to look at other development projects which are more advanced in their journey and which require cash. And we are continually seeking out those opportunities.
I wanted to ask you about some recent news that you had out, the most recent being the drill program at Stoke and a very successful one. Can you talk a bit about Stoke as a project and what the work that you've done there?
Yeah, I think to give you a context, our strategy here has been focus on creating a project pipeline of gold and gold-rich base metals. Yeah. And our technical team determined that there is a lot of latent opportunity in the three mineral properties in Eastern Townships, namely Clinton, Stokes, and Harvey Hill. And these deposits are in the vicinity of past producing mines. And our team did a great job in Q1 and Q2, and we completed a drill program on all three properties around 3,000 meters. And I am very pleased to share that we got very good results, not only in Stokes, but also Clinton as well. And we are very encouraged by these results, and we plan to follow up with the further drill program on both Clinton and Stokes. So on Stokes, your specific question, we found you know, one hole intersecting 98 meters of continuity of copper, which is great, and which helps us to kind of plan the next phase of exploration and increase the zone of mineralization and increase the confidence in these two properties. And we believe that since there has been a lot of past drilling in both Clinton and Stokes areas in the past, we believe that there is a very good potential, and we will be able to grow the resource on both these properties as we go forward. And that's really our plan for the next round of exploration, where the prep work our technical team is doing at present. And we'll focus on expanding the zone of mineralization in Clinton. We want to define the anomaly and define the mineral properties contours better in Stokes. And there are a few other properties like DeLeo Lake and Grasset, where also our team is doing some field work as we speak now.
You also had some recent news out in relation to Copper Lake and McFaulds and a deal with KWG. Can you talk a bit about that one? It's a pretty significant one.
Yeah, this really has been something which I would say is fantastic. The markets have not yet recognized the enormity of the deal which we have done. I would like to remind...
You're not alone in that, so don't worry. Everyone's feeling that heat.
Yes. So this property, just to give a context to your viewers, is in the famous Ring of Fire area in Northern Ontario. And I would like to recall to everybody that recently there was a bidding war between BHP and Wyloo for acquiring the Noron ground. And mm-hmm. our mineral property, this joint venture which we had, was right in the middle of that. And KWG was the operator. We decided to kind of clear the path or clear the decks for monetizing our asset. And we flipped a 50% shareholding to KWG. And what have we got in return? A, it helps KWG lead this whole initiative of trying to grow and build this very unique property in the Ring of Fire. B, we have got a secured promissory note of $34.5 million. Mm-hmm. And which means that that's what we'll get over 4 or 5 years' time. And we can enjoy the upside by converting this promissory note into shares of KWG. So in that sense, the upside for us is that KWG does well, progresses on its strategic plan to move forward this you know, strategic and important asset, then Fancamp stands to gain over a period of time. And there are some several other benefits. We have got warrants, we have got royalty, you know, we have got a 6% coupon. So all in all, we are very pleased with this transaction, and we believe it will be accretive both for Fancamp and KWG.
All right. And Rajesh, just as we wrap up here, give me some thoughts on, you know, over the winter and into spring as well, what we could expect from the company. It sounds like it's going to be as busy as it was this year, which was very busy for you.
Absolutely. So a couple of things. One is, as I said, with the positive results on both Clinton and Stokes property, yeah, we are going to go ahead with the drilling and exploration plan. And that's what the team is working on right now to decide and design it. Secondly, I didn't mention about it. I did mention about it briefly, but we have a strategic investment in a rare earth elements company, Neoterics Mining. And we are hoping over the next 2-3 quarters that company will go public. And that would be another you know, kind of area where Fancamp can move forward and get value as Neoterics kind of executes its plans. Yeah. The third, as I said, is the kind of KWG property and the KWG progress. And the last one, which I think did not come up, is EDM Resources, is another company where we have invested. We are one of the largest shareholders, or probably the largest shareholders. And they just signed an offtake agreement. And I am very eager to see how they close the financing in the next few months and start developing the project. And that project can come up in production between 6 to 9 months of starting the progress. So these are the exciting opportunities which Fancamp is working on. And I hope your viewers will also find them interesting and accretive and will take interest in the company.
Well, Rajesh, it sounds like it is going to be a busy time for you, and we really appreciate your time. Thank you so much for putting it all together and wrapping it up in a nice bow for everyone. So really appreciate you. Thank you.
Thank you for having me, Steve. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
All right, there's Rajesh Sharma, the CEO of Fancamp Exploration.